It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Okay, basketball fans, with me, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, I'm Ernie Johnson. You're watching 2K Sports, but you know that already. We'll watch the Charlotte Hornets in this one as they go up against the Milwaukee Bucks. Last game for Milwaukee.
Everyone to another presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. Alongside Chris Webber and Greg Anthony, I'm Kevin Harlan, the fourth member of our crew. From the sideline, Hall of Famer David Aldridge. And back in Charlotte following the road trip, it's the Hornets back on their home floor. They came away with the victory in their last meeting, which, by the way, was also in this building.
Yeah, and fortunately for them, I thought the opponent's defense just never showed up.
But I like that they attacked those weaknesses. They made them pay for a lackluster effort.
And before we get going, let's hear from David Aldridge on the sideline. David?
Well, guys, Giannis Antetokounmpo is the Bucks.
And the Bucks just one title back in 1971. D.A., thank you. This should be a fun one to watch tonight, C-Web. No shortage of athleticism for either of these teams.
Oh, get your popcorn ready. This is highlight reel material. Keep your head on the swivel, or you might get dunked on. And if you're a fan, keep your head on the swivel, or you might miss a nice dunk.
Here are the starters for Milwaukee. Middleton and Giannis are out on the wings. Brook Lopez is out there with Ilyasova, and it's Bledsoe in at the point guard. Shoots the three, knocks down the three ball. Bledsoe's got the first bucket of the night, a three-pointer for the Bucks.
And, guys, this is what you like to see early on, gaining a little confidence from range.
Well, I wouldn't say that's his shot, but it's a shot he can make. And that really opens things up for the offense.
Yeah, good awareness there. He sees an opening and doesn't hesitate.
Well, that opening right there, that's just because the defense failed to rotate.
And Antetokounmpo. Good, and Bledsoe gets the assist.
Really well done there. Just confident and composed, never in a hurry.
Pass to Lamb. AI with it. Lopez is there. AI passes to Kaminsky. Kaminsky sets the pick for Walker. And not going to go. He misses the first attempt on the night. Here's Antetokounmpo. Kemba Walker comes up with the loose ball. So the Bucks, their last game, a win against the Spurs. Bledsoe comes over to help. Shot's good by Walker. Walker's got his first points of the night.
And for a guy who only stands 6'1", I mean, Walker can be a strong finisher in the painted area.
Ilyasova dishes to Bledsoe. Ball's knocked loose. Lopez kicks to Middleton. Walker against Bledsoe. No good. Walker with some nice D. For Charlotte, they've gone 2-for-4 from the field so far today. And finished off by Kaminsky.
It's hard to shake Kaminsky. I mean, even when you rough him up, he sticks with the task at hand.
Frank Kaminsky, a finesse 7-footer out of Wisconsin. A high skill level, but athletically at a disadvantage most nights.
Bledsoe passes to Antetokounmpo. Ilyasova a screen. And he makes the bucket through contact and gets the whistle, too.
Nice way to start the evening. His number's getting called, and for good reason.
Well, yeah, he's a guy who can carry you for stretches, long stretches in this game. You want to get him involved early and often.
And Batum kicks to AI. Fouled on the shot, so the bucket counts, and a chance for one more here.
And you knew with the rise to stardom that AI has enjoyed, shoe companies would come knocking. It was just announced he will partner up with Jordan to promote their line.
And from what I heard, Greg, AI had several suitors come to him with shoe offers. All in all, just another big step for one of the better stories in the NBA. C-Web, one area where the Hornets really improved last season, offensive rebounding.
Oh, yeah, they've been good on the defensive boards for a while, but when they added Dwight Howard, suddenly the second chance opportunities begin to pile up. I mean, I don't know if they can maintain this without Dwight Howard, who's one of the best rebounders of the generation.
Now Batum following the three-point attempt by Eric Bledsoe. Outside, Walker launches it. That's in. He's got two made now, and he's shooting two for three.
He's got some pep in this stuff tonight. I wonder what he had to eat last night. I mean, very solid first quarter for him at the offensive end.
Antetokounmpo against Batum. Takes it off the glass. And it's 7 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo. Charlotte leading by three. And Walker kicks to Batum. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Good D by Lopez.
I'm sure he thought that was good when they left his fingertips. Matter of fact, I know he did.
Stolen by Walker. And here we go. Fast break, and AI's got it. Can't connect from short range. Batum against Antetokounmpo. Good, and it's his fourth basket of the game. He's a strong 4 for 6.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
And now the first timeout called here for the Hornets.
Yeah, just hitting the reset button, a chance to kind of talk some things over.
And the chance to draw up a great play. I mean, this is a chess match at work.
And now we have a moment to recognize the player of the week in the Eastern Conference, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Well, you talk about a player displaying complete dominance on the floor. This is it. And it seemed like he could do no wrong as he was a factor in really every facet of the game. A truly remarkable performance.
Now, here's Batum. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. A nice shot by AI.
Well, when Batum, Kevin, spots a wide-open teammate, he zips the rock to him quickly. Just exceptional vision.
Bucks trail by three. Antetokounmpo dishes to Lopez. Ilyasova is screen on Batum. Here's Antetokounmpo.
Come on. Did you see that?
He is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think. And that was an Unleash Chaos replay, courtesy of Under Armour, wreaking havoc at the rim. And so here's Charlotte, following the bucket by the Bucks. AI can't hit. And there's the foul. It'll go on AI. That's his first foul. Milwaukee has gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Lopez outside. Ilyasova a screen. Lopez passes to Antetokounmpo. Batum with the steal. Fast break now for Charlotte. Batum's running. Here's Lamb. Not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down. Lamb's got his first points of the night. Pass to Ilyasova. They set the screen. Poked away. Fast break now for the Hornets. Lamb with the ball. Eric Bledsoe covering. And it's Brook Lopez with the foul. That's his first foul. Marvin Williams has checked in for the Hornets. The Bucks also with the sub. Malcolm Brogdon's checked in for Chris Middleton. And there's the foul. It goes on Ilyasova. That'll be his second foul of the game.
And that's his second foul already, and that's going to force him to tone down his aggression defensively.
Looking at who's out there now for the Hornets. Zeller, he's checked in for Frank Kaminsky. Monk comes in for Nicholas Batum. And Parker subbed in for Walker. The Bucks also changing it up. Tyler Zeller's checked in for Lopez. Henson comes in for Ilyasova. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Eric Bledsoe. Here is Dellavedova, covered by Parker. Here's Antetokounmpo, and it's AI with the rebound. AI's got his third rebound on the night. Well, great leaping ability, such an advantage in this game of basketball, Chris, when you think about the bigs who can control that kind of part of their game. Who comes to mind for you?
You have to go out there to look at that man, DeAndre Jordan. I mean, he dunks, it looks like a Nerf hoop. He just throws it up there, the way that he gets up. Or how about Drummond, the way that he can get 20 rebounds in just a second? How quick he is at getting that second step and going back up. When I think of the athletic big man, I think of Andre Drummond as one of the most athletic big men that I've ever seen in my time playing basketball.
And there's the three-second violation. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist is checked in for AI. Hornets have been good at the free throw line. This one, 7 of 8.
And taking a look at their free throw statistics on the season, right around 74%.
The free throw drops for Kaminsky.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
Setting the floor for the Bucks. Middleton and Giannis are out on the wings. Ilyasova out there with Brooke Lopez. And it's Bledsoe in at the point.
On that play, I mean, it feels even better to be the guy setting the screen than the guy scoring the points.
And Walker kicks to Lamb. There's the pass to AI. And right on through for another basket. He's got 5 made on 5 of 9 shooting.
Yeah, and their shooting really starting to pick up here in the second.
Now, here's Antetokounmpo. A 32-point game for him in the win against San Antonio.
Yeah, but it wasn't all about himself. He also did a great job at creating for his teammates. So many assists tonight.
No good from Bledsoe.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Lopez with the steal. Bucks trail by 11. Bledsoe kicks to Antetokounmpo. Middleton outside. His first shot coming late. It's rebounded by Charlotte. AI's got his 5th rebound in this one. To the middle. Stolen by Middleton. 4-on-3 break. Here's Bledsoe. And a great assist by Antetokounmpo as that one goes in. Antetokounmpo's got 3 assists in the game. Charlotte leading by 9. Passes it to Lamb. And Batum kicks to AI. That one falls through. It's his 6th make from the floor this game. Now 6 for 10.
Indicative of what we've seen tonight. One team being the aggressor, the other failing to react.
You know the saying, numbers don't lie. You can see it up there on the scoreboard.
Back to Bledsoe, off the screen, and that's 2 points on the layup. Bledsoe's got 4 this quarter.
A tough start scoring the basketball, but they're starting to turn it around now.
Batum passes to Kaminsky. And Lamb kicks to AI. Charlotte moving the ball around. Lock at 6. On the wing, Lamb connects from 3-point range. Lamb's got the lead up to 12 now for the Hornets.
And they've done a great job knocking down those long-range shots here in the second, shooting just over 40% from downtown.
Now here's Middleton. He picked up 18 points in their last win against San Antonio. Lopez, a screen on Walker. There's the foul. It's on Jeremy Lamb. That is his first foul of the game. For a long time, beat writers and media personnel have determined NBA awards. C. Webb is someone who's been up for some of these. Do you feel the voting system structured now is fair?
I don't know how it can be fair if it doesn't have any players or coaches involved. I can't necessarily vote on the best doctors because I don't know what it entails, but I can definitely trust other doctors to give their comments on their peers. I think peer awareness is some of the most reliable that you can go for. But, I mean, we have some very knowledgeable writers, sports writers, and media personnel that know. But for the most part, you need help of the players and the coaches to make sure that the integrity is there.
Here's Warriors land after Eric Bledsoe's score. And Batum kicks to AI. Back to Batum. And Charlotte again with the bucket.
Well, that just speaks to the confidence Batum has in himself. He likes to catch and shoot, Jay, because it catches defenders off their guard.
Pass to Antetokounmpo. Shoots over Batum. That shot, no good. And the Hornets now going the other way. Atlanta will be traveling to face them after this game. And that's game two of this string of four games played at home. Kicks to AI. Got it. Number seven on the night. 7 for 11 from the floor.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys. And it's paid off.
Pass to Antetokounmpo from 13, and it's wide right. It's off the rim. Hornets leading by 14. Knocked away, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Antetokounmpo. A moment now to see how the schedule is looking coming up for the Charlotte Hornets. On Wednesday, it'll be the Atlanta Hawks coming into town. Then on Friday, they'll be matching up against Rudy Gobert and the Utah Jazz.
And looking at that Timberwolves matchup, this is one where it would take a complete meltdown for them not to come away with the win. Anything can happen, but I'd be shocked if they don't come out on top. And a terrific percentage here in the first half. You gotta love their rhythm and the flow with which they're playing.
Well, it's the shot selection. That's been a positive for them thus far and a negative for their opponent.
Now, here's Walker following the miss by Giannis Antetokounmpo. Here's AI. He makes his ninth shot of the game. He has only missed four.
Just increasing their advantage. And right now, they're in a zone on both ends.
Oh, that's why you see them flexing a little bit. They're feeling good about how they've dominated.
Bledsoe passes to Middleton. Outside, Antetokounmpo. There's the pick. Now the pass to Lopez. To the inside. They need this. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. And that's 11 points for Eric Bledsoe.
It was a tough first quarter for him, but it's been a different story here in the second.
AI sends a screen for Batum. At the elbow, it's AI. The Hornets need to get a shot off here. And it's blocked.
We'd love to see more of this from Ilyasova. I mean, he has to reach the swat away shot.
And wait to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
Yeah, but look at the basket guy still shaking. Charlotte calls timeout. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
I tell you what, how efficient they were at scoring the basketball, especially for an away game, that was impressive. Good.
And so it's Charlotte holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. They're playing up. Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action. Getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. Really an incredible game from AI.
And I'll tell you, his work on the blocks in that first half, really impressive.
Oh, yeah, especially how he established great position and showing some nice footwork and really read how the defense was playing.
While we've got a moment, let's set the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half. On the floor for Charlotte. Batum outside at the three with Kaminsky at the four. Kemba Walker is out there with Jeremy Lamb. And it's AI in at the five. And that's out of bounds. Charlotte will retain possession. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, guys, it seems every season new records are set for the number of three-pointers made and attempted. It's proven to be successful, and of course, it is a copycat league. It's hard to know why it took so long for everyone to catch on, but now that they have, the effects continue to ripple throughout the league.
They sure have, David. Thank you. There's the screen. Bledsoe kicks to Middleton. Outside, Antetokounmpo. Passes it to Lopez. Over AI. And And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the content. NBA rosters are turning over faster, it seems, these days. Chris, how much do former teammates know about defending one another? Or is it a non-issue?
Oh, no, it's more than a non-issue, Kevin. You are right in your assumption that, listen, your former teammates, they have a little more inside information. And you know why it matters? Because every day after practice, you know, the first thing guys do after they get their water, they play one-on-one. So you understand guys' tendencies, you learn how they get into a rhythm. We're all creatures of habit. Let's remember what Kevin Durant did. Remember how he came down on the same end of the floor in the finals and hit the same tough shot over the extended hand that he did? Well, if you notice, he did that on his crossover, that right-to-left setup. And so if you know him, you may know that he's going to do that. And also, you may know that he has a counter just in case. It allows you to keep your hand out the cookie jar, not to gamble. It gives you an educated guess on maybe what some of the greatest offensive players in the world are going to go to next to get that bucket. Any piece of information matters. And yeah, if you've been practicing against them, that's a good thing.
Free throw good, AI. And the Bucks with possession here, down by 12. They'll be playing host to Chicago for their next game. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again. It's Antetokounmpo on the wing, defended by Batum, and good that time. 19 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Defensively, this is what you know. He's coming off a hot game and looking to keep it rolling.
Yeah, but here's the problem. They play team ball. So if you pay him too much attention, that just leaves other guys open and it's too difficult of an adjustment to make.
Inside, Lopez. Four on the clock. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. And now we go to our rookie leaderboard to get a check on the players at the top of the freshman class in assists over the last 10 games. You look at AI, top five in the NBA, and his teammates love him.
Impressive dime count there, and you like to see that from a rookie. No better way to make a first impression than by spreading the wealth.
An effective low post score with a feathery touch. Lopez continues to prove his worth in his league.
Charlotte leading by 9. And Walker kicks to Batum. AI in the post. Lopez is there. And AI throws it down.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. Bledsoe outside. Milwaukee, no good that time either.
All the time in the world to get that one off.
Lamb passes to AI. The shot from the low post is good. AI's got 29 in the game.
No doubt about the consistency when it comes to scoring the basketball for him tonight. A real nice lift for their offense.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
And Middleton kicks to Antetokounmpo. And the shot is good. The Hornet lead has been cut down to 11 on the bucket from Lopez.
A selfless teammate. Ilyasova is fantastic at setting screens and creating space for his guys.
Pass to AI. And Charlotte again with the bucket.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from the paint.
Here's Lopez, and a great assist by Bledsoe as that one goes in. Bledsoe's got three assists tonight. Eric Bledsoe, Greg, one of the league's best slashers.
Yeah, he gets to the rim with regularity, and he finishes at a high rate, lives at the line. He is a nightmare in the open court.
He continues to be their go-to guy. If they close this game out, his stamp will be all over this league.
He kicks it to Middleton. Ilyasova, a screen. Back to Bledsoe. High, arcing shot. That shot, no good. Walker with some nice deep. Batum passes to AI. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. That's on Brook Lopez. And the first one at the line is good. Charlotte making a switch here. Hernan Gomez is checked in. So he hits one of two from the stripe. Bucks trail by 14. Antetokounmpo kicks to Bledsoe. Sinks the triple. Bledsoe's got 14 points for the game.
He's one of the guys having a solid game for them, but as a whole, they've been lacking.
Outside, Batum. AI, right side. Lays it up off the glass. AI's got 36.
And he's really made the most of his opportunities today. I mean, he needs to keep working for those kinds of looks.
Outside, Antetokounmpo. Bledsoe with it. He's picked up by Walker. Here's Antetokounmpo. Good, and Bledsoe gets the assist. Bledsoe's got his fourth assist in this one.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Pass to Lamb. Deflects the pass. AI right side. And stolen by Ilyasova. And it's the Bucks on the break. Antetokounmpo running.
And really, the ceiling for Antetokounmpo is limitless. I mean, he has the potential to be a Hall of Famer.
And we've made our way through just over a minute and a half in this fourth quarter. Count that one.
Still attacking. Building on this lead, coming down the stretch.
Well, what I like about it most is he's doing it efficiently.
Setting the floor for the Bucks. Middleton and Giannis are out on the wing. Brook Lopez is out there with Ilyasova. And it's Bledsoe in at the one spot. Stolen by Bledsoe. And now in transition is Bledsoe. Here we go. And he gets the bucket.
Leaving the rest of the field in the dust.
Well, while he's out there making a play, everyone else is watching. Solid individual effort right there.
Tipped away. Stolen by Middleton. Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now. Antetokounmpo, no good. Hornets leading by 8. Walker with a clean look. Off target from three-point range. Antetokounmpo against Batum. To the paint, the 11-footer misses off the left iron.
Almost every look he gets inside is a good one, but the D hangs in there and makes it a tough one.
That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. And the Hornets lead by 11.
Well, Batum is a volume three-point shooter. If he has any space whatsoever, he's pulling up, most likely connecting.
They get it back. Charlotte has gotten the three-point shot off 16 times tonight. 7 times they've hit it, 9 times they've missed. And the basket by Kaminsky.
Good movement there. And the lead pass was right where it needed to be.
Bucks trail by 13. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Yep, that one goes in there. 27 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo. Charlotte has gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. Bledsoe against Walker. And that one's good. AI. AI's got 40 points.
But they've got this lead because he's at the top of his game. He has been the story tonight.
Here's Antetokounmpo, and he banks in the layup.
Look, and when someone's open, Lopez will find them, using his height to see over the defense.
AI, left side. A second chance effort, and the layup is good. AI's got 6 here in this quarter.
Oh, tough effort right there on the glass. Those second chance points can pay off in a big way.
Lopez kicks to Antetokounmpo. Ilyasova, a screen. Back to Lopez. He tries for three, and a great assist by Antetokounmpo as that one goes in. Antetokounmpo's got 10 assists here tonight. So active. At the elbow, it's AI. And Charlotte again with the bucket.
The entire offense has revolved around him today, and that's been the perfect game.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. We've seen AI really making a difference here.
There should only be one thing they're talking about in this timeout, trying to deny him the ball in the paint before he does any more damage.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, guys, I was able to listen to what Mike Budenholzer told his team during that timeout. He was not happy with their defensive performance. He said they're getting everything they want. We've got to show them we can't let that happen. You have to make a stand. You have to get some stops, and that'll get us going on a run. Guys?
Ilya Sova is a player who bounced around quite a bit in the last few years. He's always found a way to be productive, though, wherever he lands. He doesn't give you anything too flashy, but he can get you some numbers in a few different columns.
And Ilya Sova, always a threat to end up with a double-double.
Ilya Sova has always been great at grabbing rebounds. I mean, even in limited minutes, he'll grab some boards, finish some plays for you. He's also decent with his shot selection and how much he'll force an offer.
And that one misses.
And he has been grinding away to get himself to the line. It hasn't always turned into points, but he's doing a lot of the dirty work for them.
Bucks trail by 11. Lopez sets a screen for Antetokounmpo. Off the mark, had a chance to trim it to single digits.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
The shot by Middleton, wide open. And a great assist by Bledsoe as that one goes in. Bledsoe's got assist number 5 here tonight. And Walker kicks to Batum. Kaminsky with the ball. Charlotte moving the ball around. Outside, Batum. Here's AI. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. AI's got 47 points.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Back to Middleton. It's tipped over Lamb. Middleton can't get it to go. Hornets leading by 10. Here's Lamb. Inside, AI, and AI throws it down.
But really, Lamb, he's a jack-of-all-trades kind of player, a superb passer with good instincts.
Milwaukee's gone 3 of 4 from downtown here in the fourth. Batum against Antetokounmpo. Middleton can't get it to go.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
Well, in addition to Batum's solid perimeter shooting, he is also very efficient from the mid-range, dropping in these shots consistently.
Bledsoe passes to Antetokounmpo. Batum with the steal. Now here's Walker. Outside, Batum. And the pass to Lamb. 6 to shoot. Here's AI. And another one. That gives him 51.
Making it look easy.
Bucks trail by 16. Outside, Antetokounmpo. Kicks it to Bledsoe. Ilyasova, a screen on Walker. Here's Bledsoe, and sticking right with it, gets the foul with the bucket, and he'll go to the line.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
And here's Walker. Pass to Lamb. AI, left side. using his post move to get the 2 points. AI's got 53.
I tell you what, I don't know what he did in the locker room, but he needs to do a little bit more of it because he's on fire.
Lopez a screen. Here's Antetokounmpo. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It's on Nicholas Batum. And he makes the first. That one is no good.
They're looking to get the most out of every possession. Frustrated and miss even one free throw.
Pass to Lamb. He kicks to AI. Fouled in the act of shooting. A three-point play chance coming up.
And this is going to end in a lopsided victory. I love the tenacity and aggressiveness as well as the ability to close. You really got to give it up here for Charlotte.
In the end, they had a better shooting percentage, and that's what made the difference. Sometimes, you know, things go your way. The other team wasn't catching any lucky breaks themselves.
Yeah, and Kevin, not all about luck. I thought their overall shot selection was better.
And so this will now translate to 14 wins on the season.
And as we get set to put this one to bed, a one-sided season series thus far, they've won two straight.
And, you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for AI.
Well, he showed what it takes to be a great rebounder tonight. Fighting for position, boxing out, never getting outworked down low.
1:29 left in the fourth quarter. And Zeller kicks to Muhammad. Back to Zeller. Now here is Dellavedova. He's covered closely. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in.
Oh, such a feel shot there, the floater.
Charlotte leading by 15. Pass to Monk. To the inside. Parked down low that time, and he got the three-second call. It's been a few years now since rules were put into place to curb the hack-a-shack. That free throw good from Brogdon. Here's Walker. 52 seconds left in the fourth quarter. To the paint. Here's AI. Milwaukee with the rebound. Middleton up top. Here's Brogdon. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. First one falls for. So an almost entirely new group in now for Charlotte. So no problem for Charlotte as they get the win. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that opportunity. And this is what they came out to do.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Alders, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long, everyone.
AI, Griff standing by for an interview.
Oh, yeah?
What's up, Griff?
What's up, guys?
AI.
Come on over.
Thank you. I wanted to ask about your teammates. How do you feel your relationship is with them now that you've had some time in the league under your belt?
Man, the short answer is I couldn't do it without these guys. You know, the camaraderie in the locker room is great, and I feel like I've really grown as a player, as a person, you know, working with these guys. Hey, we all out there looking to win games, right? And it's so much easier to do that when we all on the same page.
Sounds like one big happy family.
I guess you could say that, yeah. You know what? Go ahead. Write that one down. That's good.
It's all right here. All Thanks right. again for the time, AI.
Thank you, guys. Have a good one.
Pass it on, AI. Get some rest.
Anywhere you go, give it all. Anywhere you say, anywhere you say, anywhere.